My name is David Whitney, and I'm a faculty in the Vision Science program. I'm also in the Psychology department, and you'll find as you explore the Vision Science program that faculty are often cross-appointed in many departments. Vision Science has optometry people in Psychology department, as I am, also in neuroscience, in engineering, computer science, physics, biology, across the entire campus. And this is one of the strengths of Vision Science, is a program. We have faculty in all of the departments across campus. And so if you are a student interested in perception, which is what a lot of us Vision Science faculty and labs study, then Vision Science program is a perfect place to be, because our graduate students who enter the program can study perception from a number of different perspectives within a number of different departments and at multiple levels of analysis. One of the main focuses of the Vision Science program, you'll find, is on human perception. And that's something that I and many of my colleagues focus our research on in our lab's research. We study things like object recognition and face perception, how we perceive crowds of stimuli. If you encounter a crowded restaurant, how do you find your friend in that restaurant? Why is it so difficult to find a friend's face in the crowd? Why is it so difficult to find anything in a naturally cluttered scene? We have naturally cluttered scene all around us all the time. And we move our eyes around to try to overcome that clutter, to try to find the objects that we're interested in. But making eye movements isn't quite enough. Even when we make those eye movements, we still face lots of clutter in the environment, and it makes it hard to recognize objects. So some of the students in the Vision Science program are interested in understanding how the visual system overcomes the challenges of perceiving in a cluttered world, how we overcome the challenge of limited processing in the visual system, the capacity limitations of vision. So to study how we perceive faces, how we perceive cars and other objects, how we perceive scenes, entire scenes, and how we overcome the challenges that clutter presents, the students in the Vision Science program use psychophysics, studying human perception or how the physical world relates to perceptual outcomes. Students are using physiological techniques like EEG and fMRI. Other students are using a variety of different kinds of techniques at many levels of analysis. Some of our students are interested in motion perception, how it is that we perceive tennis balls coming at us. They come at us at 120 miles an hour, and yet somehow tennis players can get their racket on that ball. So how does our visual system work so quickly, so efficiently, and so powerfully that we can interact with fastballs coming at us? And how do we localize objects? How do we dodge that car coming at us? How do we across the street when there are so many cars driving around? How do we keep track with our attention of so many objects all over the visual field? These are some of the questions, and there are many out there. These are just some of the questions that our students in the Vision Science program are interested in answering. And of course, these students have interest in psychology and neuroscience, but they also have interest by the nature of the questions that they're asking. They have interest in computer science and engineering and biology. And by studying vision at multiple levels, from the lowest levels, single cells, even the molecular level, all the way up to the systems level and behavior level, our students can get a much broader understanding of vision and visual perception than almost any other program out there. In fact, we have more faculty interested in perception than virtually any program in the world. There are over 20 PIs at UC Berkeley who are interested primarily in visual perception. If you look at the broader Bay Area, Berkeley is a great place to be because there are faculty across many campuses, and we have regular interactions across these campuses. There are Bay Area meetings on vision more than twice per year. So Berkeley in particular and the Bay Area are great places to study vision science. And if you want to study vision science, there is no better place than UC Berkeley.